All right. Thank you, everyone, for joining the call. This session is for Azure AD Connect Deep Dive, and I welcome you all. Myself, I am Radhakrishnan Govindan, also known as RK. I have a 10 plus years experience in IT and working as a senior consultant. And I am a Microsoft MVP and C Sharp Corner MVP, and I also do Microsoft certified trainer, and I hold certificate in various technologies in terms of server, Exchange, Office 365, and Azure. On top of that, I'm a blogger, and I maintain a website called WindowsTechPro.com, and I do write up on all Windows, and Microsoft products. So today's agenda. Can you meet everyone if you are not talking, please? All right. Today's agenda, we are going to see what is Azure AD Connect and understanding the architecture, how it works, and upgrading Azure AD Connect paths and Azure AD Connect scheduler. After that, we will have a question and answer session. There we will be answering to your queries. All right. First of all, what is Azure AD Connect? By default, Azure AD Connect provides uniformity between your on-premises and cloud. Before cloud come in picture, there was a technology called Identity Manager in on-premises. That's where your multiple organizations were using it to merge their Outlook gals and other identities. After that, when cloud came in picture, initially directory sync was launched, which used to install in on-premises server, and it will sync up your on-prem Active Directory user and objects or computers to the cloud. So why we are using AD Connect directory sync? Because on-premises you have identities, and same way when you are using cloud, there will be two different identities. To avoid that, different identities and getting collision in terms of user list, that's where directory services provides syncing on-prem to cloud, and user in cloud or on-premises, they will see uniformity in their GAL. And also it uses to create a group groups and security groups in cloud, dynamic DLs, and provide permission for on-prem use users. And why we use specifically Azure AD Connect? Can't we use another technologies in terms of, yes, we can use other technologies if it is allowing to sync, but Azure AD Connect is a simple mechanism and created by Microsoft. It is a lightweight engine, sync engine. It allows sit in the on-prem backbone server. It is not required any DMZ or in terms of any ports not required for AD Connect. Simple backbone where internet you have in the server, you can install the Azure AD Connect. It will start syncing on-prem to cloud. Sync engine, there will be two namespaces will be there. One is connector namespace, and another one is metaverse. Connector namespace will allow you to connect with your Active Directory or SQL database, and the metaverse is the aggregated list of your on-prem and cloud. That is where you will get what needs to be synced to cloud and what needs to be exported to the cloud. Connective directory in terms of it is Azure Active Directory or else SQL. That's where you are on Azure directory will get dumped into SQL. Your connectivity engine will compare both. This is how it will look. What will happen when connectivity directories are there? This is Active Directory or SQL database, and there will be a connector in terms of it is connecting to your connector space or metaverse. By default, database, it will be in the hierarchical format or different format, and sync engine won't understand this, the format. That's where connector comes in picture, and it will enable to to create a format which can be synced to cloud. In connector space, there will be stage object and placeholders. Stage object is nothing but whatever you have on-premises. When it is syncing to cloud, it won't sync directly to the cloud. First, it will connectivity. First, this connector will contact connectivity directories. It will get the data to the sync engine. Sync engine take that data into connectivity space. There, it will compare the whatever synced to cloud or anything needs to be created newly or old data needs to be synced, and that's where. Excuse me. So when a new user getting created in on-premises, that will say get into sync engine. Sync engine will see whether it is new one or old user. If it is new user, it will create a directly to the cloud. If it is old one, what will happen? Say example, new user one is there. His manager got added in his object. So that there. Sync engine, what it will do, it will create a staged object in terms of this user as a new update which needs to be synced to cloud, that value called manager. That is where staged object it will come in picture, and that once staged object came in picture, what will happen? Sync engine, it will validate, it will go and talk to the directory services. It will take that value and manager. It will export all the values to the. Hello. One minute. Let me. So. What will happen when user is getting created in the directory services, that it will using connector, it will go to the connector space, there the data will be validated, and then that data will be went into metaverse will validate that user is a new user or old user. Then it will keep a flow telling that this user is as a value to update, that has to go to cloud. Then this metaverse, what it will do, it takes that value to the Office 365 connector. Then that connector will validate this user object already there or not. If it is there, then it will start syncing up to the cloud using that particular object. This is how it works. If you see connector connector directories will be there, it will take the value to the connector space, then the import object will come, metaverse will see that value, then that metaverse value send it to the export object, and using the connector it will sync up to the Azure or in terms of on-prem also if you are having write back options. What is metaverse objects? How it will look? Why we use metaverse? Metaverse is an aggregated format between both connectors. In terms of, if you have multiple connectors, for example, you have a different directories or different domains, you created multiple connectors. It doesn't mean you have multiple connectors, it has to show multiple values. So that is where metaverse objects, what it will happen, it will get objects from multiple connectors, and it will combine it as a single one, and it will show this is a unique one which has to be synced to connectivity directories. Say example, one user one created in the platform active directory, and same user in cloud, when you go and search for that user, it should not show two different user one objects. So it will create a confusion, which is on-prem, which is cloud. So Metaverse, what it does, it will combine both and it will show single object. On top of that, it will add the single connector object, this import and export objects in that. I'm going to show you how it will look. For now, you just keep it in mind, it is aggregated format of multiple connectors. It will not show you duplicates, it will be single one. And in Sync Engine, Metaverse object will be globally unique one, which means it will have a GUID created. That GUID will be globally unique. And one user, if created GUID, that will not be assigned to different user. And so connector, so what will happen if new user or existing user data values getting changed, right? By default, when Active Directory created a user or modified user, the connector will send it to the connector space will not take the value by default. It will compare it with existing database, what it maintains in terms of SQL database or your SQL Express. So it will compare that value, be it in actual on-premises or cloud. The Sync Engine will not take the value without comparing with the database what it has. So it will take that as an input and compare that. Then it will create a linked jointed objects. Jointed object is nothing but it has a new value. That value has to be sent to the cloud. So there will be flow created. That flow will go to the cloud. So if there will be disjointed objects as well. Disjointed object is nothing but by default, Sync Engine will be having thousands of objects. Every time it cannot go and fetch that and compare it. It will create a lot of network bandwidth and it will take a lot of time to sync up because the server is sitting in backbone. It has to connect with Active Directory also cloud. So what it will do? It will go and get both platforms, say Active Directory and Office 365. It will keep the value within it. So whenever new object or new updates coming for that, it will sync up other data. It will be there without doing anything. So what will happen? If example, disjointed objects are there. Currently, user one created and it went to, and user two, there is no update. That will be as a disjointed object. So next time, if any update is coming for this disjointed object, immediately it will turn it back as a jointed object. That sync will happen back. That is where in order to get updates multiple times, it will keep within it Sync Engine. Sync Engine is nothing but your Active Directory, AD Connect. So it will keep that values. As soon as it sees that update is there for that particular object, it will sync up. Object is nothing but user or computer or anything, be it mail contact, those things also it will be considered as an object. So identity management process, there will be a couple of process happens when Azure AD Connect gets installed or there is a sync up happening, right? One is import. Import is nothing but in both platforms, say you installed AD Connect, it will go and get a import from your Active Directory, also from the cloud. So that is the import process. It will import from the both places and it will keep in the database. And then it will sync up import. Once it got that, it will compare with existing database and then it will do outbound synchronization to the cloud. It is called export. So from the connector directory, Connective Directory is nothing but your on-prem, you know, Active Directory or Azure. Then import will happen. Then it will synchronize. It will synchronize with your, you know, Active Directory database and see whether it is update is there or not. Then that update will get synced to the cloud as an export. During the export process, what will happen when it is exporting some object to the cloud, it will not export and leave it. By default, user won't export it to the cloud. It will wait for the update from the cloud telling that, yes, I got an update. And then if it has got update, then it will update in the database telling that, yes, this object has been synced to the cloud and this is fine for the next sync up. So it will wait for the verification also. This is how it is. When import export happened, then it will wait for the confirmation. Back to that sync engine, nothing but AD Connect. Once it is everything verified, then it will stamp flag it out, telling that there is no update hereafter for that object. So how this is happening, right? User one getting created in Active Directory and it is going to AD Connect, then it is syncing to cloud. This all process is fine. Something is happening in behind the scenes, right? There will be something. How AD Connect will come to know? By default, when user one is there and this is the user, it has to be synced. Say example, you created user one, you deleted and recreated the user one object. So the how AD Connect identifies that, right? So by default, whenever user or data is getting into sync engine, that is nothing but your AD Connect, there will be anchor created for that. What will happen? It will take the data from the use Active Directory or Office 365. Then it will take to the sync engine. Then in Active Directory side, it will stamp one anchor telling that, yes, I got the data. This is what anchor. Next time when update is happening for that user object, it will see that anchor. Based on that anchor, that value will be stamped against that anchored object in the sync engine. Then the sync engine will compare it and it will send it back to the cloud, right? Anchor, once anchor it will be like unique one. Say example, user principal name or employee ID or object good. It will take it as a anchor object for anchor one for that user. So whenever new things are coming or any update required for that user, sync engine go and talk to the Active Directory or Office 365 and take the validate that user, and it will match that anchor whether it is matching or not. If it is matching, then that will take that and it will sync it to cloud. So this source anchor, it is not case sensitive. It can be anything, or characters or letters, numbers also can be considered. So this one, Azure AD Connect latest version facilitates MSDs consistency good as a source anchor. So employee ID also sometime get changed. So what will happen? User employee ID get changed. Active Directory will fail, AD Connect will fail. That's where, so what happens nowadays, Azure AD Connect will take MSD's consistency good as a source anchor. Based on that only, it will sync, it will see the updates and it will take further process, import, export, and synchronizations. So this is, next we are going to see, installation process. So there will be two type of installations. One is express setting installation and customized one. Express is nothing but Microsoft by default, predefined all the settings, whatever required by default for an organization to sync up to cloud. And you don't need to do anything. Just you need to provide your identities in terms of your on-premises and cloud. Once it is, provided, everything will be done behind the scenes. Express settings by default, it will install whatever required further to sync up your on-prem to cloud. So to do that, you need a on-prem administrator and a cloud global administrator for the cloud, and one server to be set up. So that server required only internet facility that has a 443 and 80 ports towards Microsoft URLs that you can get it from the from Microsoft website. So it is not required any further ports. It is working using 443 traffic, and 80 is required for the certificate validation. On 80 it is not doing anything. So customized installation. So customized one is nothing but if you have more objects in terms of you have a big organization, you have 2 lakh employees, and you are going to sync up around 2 lakh computers. Also, there will be a lot of objects around 5 lakh or 10 lakh objects. That time, you cannot go and install with default SQL Express database. So that database, because it is a 10 GB file, you cannot extend it as well. So there you need a SQL license and SQL server edition, SQL server edition installed, that you need to use it. That time you cannot go with Express. Express will take a default SQL Express. So you cannot go for Express installation. There you need to select a custom setting installation. With custom setting installation, you can modify and provide your SQL instance, and apart from that, you can select whatever you want to sync up. Say example, you want to sync user objects or computer object or specific OUs you want to sync, that also you can select in that. On top of that, Active AD Connect provides other options, features also, into ADFS and proxy and password write back, user write back options. If you want, you can select that. In this session, we are not going to see other features. We are seeing only direct sync. So I'm going to show you how AD Connect is getting installed. This is my server. It is domain joined machine. So apart from internet, it doesn't have any ports opened, and it is sitting in the Wipro's corporate backbone. If you see, it is connected. It is domain joined. It is domain joined machine, right? So you no need to install it in DMZ, or you no need to fight for firewall opens for this AD Connect. So as soon as you validated internet is there, so you can download the MSI package from the Microsoft website, Azure AD Connect. Once you download it from the website, you just double click on it. It will launch. So I already tried to install. That's where it is giving this. By default, you will get into this screen, Express settings. If you want to go for customize, you can go for it. Express setting, it will hardly take 2 minutes of time. It won't take more than that, because for typing your username and passwords only required. Apart from that, you are not going to do any modifications here. If you go and do that, it will ask for Azure AD Global Administrator credentials. You need to type your tenant, a global administrator here. Once you typed, then it will say, I will type, I'm using your Express installation to show you how it will look like. This is my Azure AD tenant global administrator username. It will validate. It will, now it is contacting cloud. So it is not, or let me type again. It is telling username and password is not correct. Sorry, here my username is wrong. It is contacting, if you see here, it is contacting Microsoft Online to verify credentials, whether my tenant, this global administrator, is there. Yes, it is validated. Now, cloud identity validation has been completed. Now it is asking for your on-premises administrator username and password. See, it is validated. It is ready to configure. It is not even taken 2 minutes of time. It's just 1 minute of time. So what and all by default Express installation does? It is configuring connectors. On top of that, it is enabling password synchronization. If you want to use password. If you want to use password synchronization, you can go for Express installation. Otherwise, you can go for custom one to disable these options. By default, if you go for Express, this will get enabled. So keep in mind, some organization, they won't allow password sync, right? That is where your hybrid setup is there. And enable auto upgrade and syncing services on this computer. And you can see, as soon as this configuration has been completed, It is asking whether to start synchronization immediately or you want to disable it. If you disable it, you need to go on. You have to go on start this. Right? This is how your Express installation looks like. Now let me take you to the custom installation. In custom installation, by default, this is the screen you will get. If you don't want to sync your password, you just disable it and click on next. It is now same process. Type your cloud global administrator credentials. Don't think this is the ID it is going to use completely for sync. What will happen as soon as you are typing global administrator username and password, it will validate this tenant is fine. This is the administrator ready to sync up. After that, Azure AD Connect, it will create its own user object on cloud. That is the object it is going to use it. I will show you how it will look after that. So as soon as you provide username and password, it will go and validate. Right, it is going to and checking all the accepted domains in cloud. Then it is coming to the screen where you need to type your on-premises Active Directory credentials. And I have a single domain name. So if you have multiple Active Directories, you can go and add them. You can use different AD credentials or you can use existing one. You can contact that and provide the credentials. And once you add that, Windows Tech Pro administrator, this is my on-prem enterprise administrator. It will now go and validate. Oh, it is giving username and password wrong. Why administrator? Let me take username and password is mismatching. Right, so once credential validated, it will show you, yes, this domain is ready to configure. And if you have multiple domains or subdomains, that and all, you can go ahead and do that. Active Directory, Azure AD Connect has a capabilities to sync up multiple Active Directory domains if you want. single AD Connect is enough to sync up multiple Active Directories. Once you added on-prem Active Directory, then click on Next. It will go and retrieve all the schema, whatever are configured in on-premises Active Directories. Now, if you see the domain is already verified, it is going and checking in the cloud this domain whether verified. Once it is verified, you can see it is asking which attribute to use for user login process or which one it can use for the identity. You can use other things if you want. By default, all the organizations, they will keep user principal name as a login credentials. If you want to change it, yes, you can go and change anything you want. This many objects available in Active Directory, this many objects you can use it for that. So I am leaving it as user principal name. User principal name is nothing but your identity at the rate your domain.com. Say example, user one at windowstechpro.com is what considered here as a user principal name. Now it is asking for the filters. This is where you can apply filters. Say example, a lot of organizations, what they will do, they create a lot of OUs in terms of to restrict our group policy. For a lot of purpose, they will create multiple OUs. So they don't want to allow all the objects sync to cloud. They want specific OUs that has to be synced to cloud, right? In that way, Azure AD Connect allows you can go and restrict them. If you don't want to sync up, by default it will go and enable all this. See here, user, system, entities, and computers, everything is getting synced up to cloud. So what will happen? All your entire on-prem Active Directory, it is going to cloud. So if you don't want to do that, you can just go and disable it. And if you want to sync only on-prem, say example, users, select it, or any other OUC created and you added that users that you need to sync up to cloud, that also you can go and select. In my case, I have created a different OU called users on-prem. This is where I'm porting all the users, on-prem users. So any user, new user getting created, I'm moving that users to here. So this user identities will get synced up to cloud, right? I am selecting this particular OU. If you don't want to do this activity and you want everything should be synced, you just select all and sync up. If you want to restrict, you select only specific one which you want, then click next. Or else during the time of configuration, you understood that yes, we need to create something. Please go ahead and create. Just refresh OU and domain here. It will go and again check for that. People are keep on asking in the chat window. Definitely I'm going to answer for all those. Please wait for some time. During the QA sessions I will answer all of these questions, right? So I have selected one particular user on premises, then I clicking on the next. Here if you see, uniquely identify your users. How you want to uniquely identify users? In terms of, by default, AD connectivity, it will take user principal name and goods. If you want to go and select a specific one, you can go and select them, whatever you want. How you want to justify that those users are unique and that particular object is not common between multiple users or multiple objects. So if you have that and you want to do that, you can go and customize it. Otherwise, leave it as it is and select as per your on-premises. Now, if you see, I told you anchor object, right? Anchor is nothing but whatever in your directories, when it is going to Azure AD Connect, it will keep on anchor. That is where your objects are getting compared between your Active Directory and AD Connect using that anchor object. If it is getting modified, new anchor object, getting stamped for that user, or else same anchor if it is matching, that is where your flow is working. So in terms of import, export, all those things. If you want to select anything specific, go and select it. If you don't want, leave it as it is. Same thing applies to Azure also. Azure by default, it has all those things. If you want to specifically mention some anchors, you can mention it, or else leave it to, you know, AD Connect maintain that anchor object, anchor connection for the source. And sync all user and devices, or you want to specific filter user and devices, you want to anything you want to specifically mention, you can do that for the pilot purpose. Or say example, AD Connect is a single server, you cannot go and install multiple servers. If you want to check that piloting whether this is doing correct things. Say example, you created a AD Connect and you did all the filters. Now you want to compare, or you want to see how it is progressing. This time what will happen, you can go and do the pilot, and that will, only that pilot group will get synced, and you can go and compare that values. Everything is fine, then you can enable it. Otherwise, leave as it is. By default, it is not going to do anything. Just it is syncing your objects. It is not going to sync up anything else apart from that. So in my case, I left it as sync all users and devices, because though I'm selecting here sync all users and devices, it is not going to sync everything, because I selected specifically one OU where I ported users alone. If computers are there in that OU, definitely it will sync up. Otherwise, it will consider only users. All right. Then optional features. This is what AD Connect by default provides features. So whenever you are installing and you are focusing only directory sync, you don't need to select all those things. If you want to use AD Connect server for other features, say example, you want to keep it as a ADFS for the purpose of ADFS, or write back password write back, or password sync, or use it as a app proxy kind of thing, you can select the features. Or else you are keeping this box alone for the directory sync, don't select any features. If you see few features are preview mode, which means it is still in the piloting mode and it is not enabled for globally, right? You will see this preview, which means if you enable it, there will be some impact. So don't consider this. If you want to test it, different box, you can install it. AD Connect for directory sync, there can be only one server. If you want to use multiple features and multiple boxes for each one, definitely you can go on to provision multiple boxes. Right. So in my case, I'm not going to select anything, because this particular box, I am going to use it for directory sync alone. If I want to keep it password write back, I can go and select it. It will go and enable that agents. So by default, Azure AD Connect runs on agent, multiple agents. Whenever you are enabling some features, that agents will get enabled on this box. So then the Azure AD Connect server will start servicing this purpose also. So better don't enable anything until you validate. If you want to test it, definitely you go and add it later on also. I'm going to show you how you can enable it later once AD Connect got installed. So in my case, currently I'm not going to select, because I want to show you how alone directory sync is getting configured. If you go and click on next, now everything's ready. You provided all the data, you selected whatever required to enable directory sync, right? Now it is ready to configure. If you are getting into this screen, which means all the validations and verifications completed, now it is ready to configure. As soon as you configure, it will start giving identity to the cloud and on-prem, telling that this I am Active Directory AD Connect. I am ready to sync up your data to the cloud, and same way from the cloud to on-premises, right? So if you want to install, then only you want to sync, go and disable it. By default, By default, it is not, it is automatic, and it is, if you want to block it, you can go on uncheck this option. And you can see another option is there, right? This another option is nothing but AD Connect. By default, only one server can be one domain. You cannot go on to keep multiple servers for directory sync. Multiple directory sync servers for single domain, you cannot keep. If you have multiple domains, for example, domain a.com, domain b.com, you want to use multiple Active Directory AD Connect servers, you can install for each domain and use it. Otherwise, you cannot keep, say, example, domain a.com, you cannot go on to provision two directory sync servers. Keep it in mind, only one directory sync server at any point in time can be used. And if you are installing another server, the latest version, which you are going to install, that will take a priority, that will go and disable old one. Say example, you have a big organization, around 40 lakh or 50 lakh objects you have that has to be synced to cloud. Okay, what will happen whenever you are configuring AD Connect server to sync that 50 lakh objects in terms of user, computer, and other things, it will take days. I have seen a company where 4 lakh around objects were there to sync up from on-prem to cloud in terms of import, sync, export. It is taking 3 days time. Think about if you have a 60 lakh or 70 lakh objects, how many days it will take, right? So what will happen if directory AD Connect server goes down? So you have option now. Previously it was not there, but recently it came up. You can keep a staged one. So what will happen, you can keep a, another box. So that another box will work as a, a standby. So as soon as your primary server goes down, you can split it up, and secondary server will take a priority, and it will start doing the job for you. Right? As soon as you click install, it will go and install it. Since I have already installed in another server for my directory sync up, I'm not going to click on next, so I'm keeping here, and then let me go to the presentation.
Can you explain once again? We didn't understand that.
Yes, please tell me.
That staging mode, what you told, can you just explain once again?
Staging mode, you have a big organization. Right, you are not able to if AD Connect server goes down, if you want to provision new server in terms of setting up the server and patches and other SQL installation, all those things, it will take some time. So during that time, what will happen, new user created or new updates are coming in, so that will not sync up to cloud until and unless that complete full sync is completes, right? By default, whenever you provision AD Connect server, it will do by default full sync. Until you complete full sync, it will not do updates. So during that time, what Microsoft is providing, you can keep a standby server. So that standby server will work as a standby. It will keep updates from the primary server. Primary means the already working server. It will be idle for the time being. As soon as this, primary server goes down, the secondary server will work as primary, and it will do the job. It will not ask you for the full thing because it has already updates.
Okay, one more thing. I have a question here. Like when we enable this AD sync server, then is it required to run continuously, or we can schedule it?
By default AD Connect server, right? It is auto scheduled. Okay, auto scheduled in terms of by default 30 minutes. Every 30 minutes once it will go on sync up. If you want to customize it, for example, you have a big organization, you don't want to do it continuously every 30 minutes once. You want to keep it for time being. Yes, definitely you can go and customize. Say example, 4 hours once, 5 hours once, that you can do that. I'm going to show you that command. Yes, it is completely customized.
And this AD Connect server needs to be deployed in the same network where this domain controller is there, right?
Absolutely, yes. Because Active, it is going to talk to your AD, because Active Directory. Active Directory is better, provision nearby Active Directory servers. It is good if you are having a small organization, you can install it on top of a Active Directory server itself, or if you want to keep it as a different box, you can keep it. But it is better to keep it nearby Active Directory site.
Okay.
You have any doubts? Okay. So let me go on here. So since I have already provisioned a server, it is already syncing up to the cloud. I'm going to stop it here, because if I click install, it will go and install it. After that, it is not going to do anything, because everything is validated. Installation will happen smoothly after this. Okay. This server is not provisioned because another server is there. So once the installation completed, right, it will start syncing. Now, what will happen if you already have a directory sync server? How you can upgrade it? See, the sync was the initial one which Microsoft launched for the syncing up your on-prem to cloud. The sync, the name called. After that, Microsoft converted its Azure AD Connect, adding on top of directory sync, adding with multiple features. As I have shown, right, password write back with the other option. So how you can upgrade if you have older version of DirSync? In place upgrade is fine. It is supportable with on top of DirSync server. And Microsoft suggesting you, if you have a DirSync and you want to upgrade it to AD Connect, and if you have more than 50k objects, right, you better provision a new server and start syncing up using AD Connect. What will happen? AD Connect direct sync, as soon as you install AD Connect, AD Connect will take a priority. It will start syncing up. You need to go and disable DirSync server, or you can go and uninstall directory sync server which has an older version. That is in place upgrade possible, but if you are running with the DirSync and you want to upgrade, better go for a different server and do it. Because I have seen scenarios in place not working as for the DirSync server. If you have already AD Connect, so older versions, 1.1, older versions. So in place upgrade, it is very much recommended, because Microsoft day by day they are porting something. Better keep auto upgrade, so it is not going to do anything. It will update the features. It will enable new features on that box. If you want to validate before upgrading, or your organization is not allowing auto upgrade, you better go and validate. And if you want to see the features, first test it in your test lab, then go and upgrade. In place upgrade is possible, and auto upgrade also possible. Auto upgrade normally people won't suggest, because we are not sure. As soon as new feature comes in and it is kicked into your AD Connect, we are not sure how it works. So better go for testing, then only you go and in place upgrade do it. So swing migration, yes, that is also possible. Swing migration is nothing. It's you are keeping a older version and you want to see how new version works, right? You can go and install new version in another box. So new version will start working. Then you can go and disable the services on the secondary server. That is called swing, which means older version server box will be there. It will be working as it is. You will provision new server as I did. As soon as you provision new server, go and disable your old server. So new provisioned server will do syncing up. You can see how it is behaving. After you are okay and verified, then you can keep the new version. This is called swing, older version to the new version. So Swing is the latest one. What I feel it is good. You can use that instead of going an in-place upgrade. So in-place upgrade by default you are installing on top of that box. You are not sure how it works. By default you do auto upgrade or in-place upgrade. Full sync will happen. I was seeing Microsoft says that it is not required full sync, but when you do in-place upgrade, it is requesting for full sync. Full sync is required, so that is where you better go and do Swing migration. And as I mentioned, staged mode, that's where I've shown you the two servers parallel will be there. Secondary server will be in idle state. It will take the updates from the primary server, but it will not sync anything. It will compare the values, everything it does, but it will not do anything. It will be idle for some time. And as soon as you want to use secondary server as a primary or primary server goes down, you can activate it. So these are all the purposes it is surviving staged mode, high availability and change your disaster recovery. So by default, one site you can keep on server, and staged server you can keep in different data center. Say example, Bangalore, you can keep on server. Second server you can keep it in Chennai or UK, US, somewhere, if you have a data centers over there. So what will happen, it will take updates from the primary, but it will not do anything as long as you are keeping it idle. When you are activating, that will work for you and it will start doing the job. It is not going to do full sync up again. It's just do the delta sync. So this is what you were asking, schedules. Yes, during the dir sync time, when you install dir sync server, there will be two schedules will be done on task scheduler, right? You can disable there, so it will stop. But in after AD Connect version came, there is no task scheduler. Okay, by default it is enabled in the engine, but you can use PowerShell commands to stop or suspend or to start the sync. The commands are very much available, PowerShell commands. You can go and do that. So by default, all the connectors, say on-prem to Azure, Azure to on-prem, all full, and delta sync is possible. You can go and do at any point in time. Say example, there is a change happened, full sync completed, and delta sync is going on. And due to some organization change, every user is getting some updates. You want to do full sync, so you can go and do that. At any point in time, you can suspend sync what is going on, and you can enable it, the new one. I mean whatever sync you want. You want full sync, you can do it. That delta sync also, at any point in time you can enable it. There is no harder you have to do. You can go and do at any anything in any order. It will go based on that order. So you can disable in both places. In on-prem AD Connect server, you can go and disable this. For some reason you are not able to reach cloud, and also you can go and disable this AD Connect syncing to the cloud. As soon as you go and disable it, the cloud will not receive any updates from here. Both places you can control sync, that's AD Connect sync. So this is the commands. So delta sync, this is the command. Full sync also, I have shown their command. Start AD sync cycle, if you do, it will start full sync. If you go on the type policy type delta or initial, it will start it. So I'm going to show you the existing server, what I have installed, and which is currently in production. It is syncing my data to the cloud. So let me take you. This is how as soon as you installed, you will not get anything in the desktop. You can go to this place called Program Files, Microsoft Azure AD Sync UISL. Under UISL, you can see MIS client. Same how it was there in Dersing, same thing. You can send it to desktop as a shortcut, or you can launch it here. As soon as you launch it, this is the window you will get it. See, if you see here, as I mentioned, there will be operations and there will be connectors created. By default, if you have one forest or one domain and one tenant, there will be two connectors created. And if you want to have multiple connectors, with multiple Active Directory domains or LDAP or any other SQL database, anything, you can go and create connectors. It is allowed. You can create connectors. And
can we delete these default connectors?
Default, yes, you can go ahead and delete it. You can go ahead and delete the connectors. If you don't want, if you want to create new one, you can go ahead and create. And if you want to, delete it, you can delete it. And if you have a customized connectors you created, say example, previous old versions, you created customized one, or your organization providing some customized connectors, you can go and import the connectors. It required XML file. So if you are, yes, please.
So scenario, we need to turn on the staging mode. For this scenario,
Staging mode is not recommended when you are going ahead and deleting connectors. So staging mode is nothing but same replica will be there in the secondary server, right?
Okay.
So replica will be there in the secondary server. For connector changes and all, not required. What you can do, go and disable the sync if it is happening during that time. And go ahead and create the connectors. Stop the sync or suspend the sync and go ahead and change the connectors. Better better keep as it as it is. After installation, don't try to modify until you have some purpose. Say example, you want to modify something like Active Directory. This is the servers you want to connect for updates, or previously you asked it should be within the same Active Directory site, right? If you have multiple Active Directory servers and some of the servers heavily loaded, AD Connect should not contact that servers, right? You can go and modify that. See here, this is Windows. This is the one which is contacting your on-prem Active Directory. This is the one is contacting cloud. You see the distinction between both, right? AD Connect on-prem is this one. This one is the cloud. So if you want to customize your on-prem sync, say example, I want to customize something. Right? So example, my AD Connect should not go and talk to all the Active Directory servers. It has to contact specific Active Directory servers for the updates. If you want to do that, go ahead and do that. This is where you can customize it. You can add particular domain controllers. As soon as you add particular domain controllers, AD Connect will talk to only those domain controllers. If you are leaving it as it is, it will go and talk to all the domain controllers. And by default, AD Connect will do LDAP traffic, encrypted traffic towards your on-prem. If you want to do something customized, you can go ahead and do it. Better keep it as LDAP. So traffic will be normal. If you have if you want to customize with enable SSL for the connection, you can do it. And the configuration you did, I configured only specific OU. After later on stage, I want to change it something else, right? So I can go ahead and select after this. As soon as I select and apply, it will start syncing that particular OU as well. So you can go ahead and customize it. By default, AD Connect will start syncing which is required objects to the cloud. In case your organization has some customized attribute for the users, you can go ahead and enable that attributes to sync up to cloud. Say example, you created some secondary manager or third manager for the user. That you have that object parameter for that user, you can go ahead and select that particular attribute also. So that attribute also will start syncing up. If you don't want to do any modification with the default one, leave it as it is. You want to sync something customized, you can go and modify that. Same way it applies to cloud also, you can go and customize it. Right? Metaverse designer, yes, you can go and design Metaverse. So Metaverse is not nothing but it is the aggregation of your, you know, connected directories. Connected directories, nothing but your on-prem and cloud. So if you want to search any user, Metaverse will search will come in picture. So example, I want to search particular user. I want to check using common name. User, there is nothing, so let me go and use user principal name. At web, oh, why it is not? So user one, sorry, there is no user. I will go ahead and select contains. So this is the user.
Hi Radhakrishnan, this is Kiran. My Hi, question Kiran. Is I have some users in Active Directory Office 365
right.
and on-premises server. I tried with Azure AD connector, mm-hmm. but from on-premises to Azure AD is getting replicated, but there is no write-back option from Azure AD to on-premises.
Mm-hmm.
Is it enabled or is it still they have not enabled the same thing?
Correct. AD Connect supports for write back. If you are having users or if you are having groups in create in cloud, right? Security groups that you need to sync
right.
up. You AD Connect supports for it, right? Write back,
okay.
you can keep it. But what mm-hmm. will happen if you are going and enabling your security persons will not allow for the write back because if
okay.
what will happen if AD Azure Active Directory getting compromised or someone
mm-hmm.
intercepting and doing something, right? So they will write back something to your on-premises, there will be problem. So you need to validate whether you want to keep it write back or not. Yes, AD Connect supports, but it's up to your organizations.
Okay, but there is one few issues we have faced at the time. What was the issue that when we used to create an user account in Active Directory, mm-hmm. it used to get updated on Azure AD with a new name, that is abc@xyz.com.
Okay.
But it was, but as we have a subscription, Office 365 subscription license ID,
uh-huh.
when we create an with a license ID, it was not able to update the same. So is there any issue with that or?
So you're syncing with your accepted domain, verified domain, right? So,
yes, right. That's correct. That's correct.
By default, if what will happen, you have on-premises, say xyz.com, right? On-premises.
Okay, right. Right.
If that user has that user principal name, user1@xyz.com, and
okay.
same tenant verified, it will go. If you have
okay.
not validated, if you are not verified that domain in cloud, okay, mm-hmm. say user one, you add
okay.
an additional SMTP address. Say example, mm-hmm. abc.com, right? That domain, if it is
right.
not validated, that will not get synced
mm-hmm.
because it will
okay.
be based on the verified domains.
Okay. For instance, if there is a verified domain and the user has been created, mm-hmm. so is it will create a new user on Azure AD? Because what those happened, we have a verified domain, one abc.com.
Okay.
And other is on local, we have xyz.com.
Uh-huh.
That xyz.com also was also verified in Azure AD.
Okay.
But it was created at the rate microsoftonline.com something at that time.
Okay, at that time it is created. So there will be chances that is this your what is you when you provisioning license, is it a hybrid environment or cloud only environment you are?
Only cloud environment, no hybrid.
So,
only cloud.
Okay, so that is where, see, user one you created in cloud, okay, that user as
right.
User one at abc.com. Okay. Obviously,
right.
That user
okay.
will be having different grid.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. In on premises, user one at xyz.com is there, but this user will be having
okay.
different grid.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So when you're syncing up, definitely it will go and create as a new user.
Okay. Got it.
Okay.
Got it. Got it. Okay. Got it. It's a different UP and YouTube which
yes,
it is.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, got it.
All right. So this is how you need to search. So if you want to see how many objects are getting to the cloud, right? See, without putting anything in the search, meta search, right? You go and do that. It will give you entire list how many objects you are syncing to cloud. In my case, in that ADU, in that OU, I'm syncing only three users. That is why it is showing. If I go ahead and you know, select the entire thing, it will give you entire list. This aggregation is based on your on-prem and cloud. It will compare both. Whatever it is combined and unique, it will show you to you here. Right? So later on, say you installed, you configured AD Connect. For some reason, you want to install another feature. Say, example, as asked, you want to write back as to be enabled in the same box, right? You can go ahead and do it. How you can go ahead and do it? There will be Azure AD Connect. This one also available in the same path, UAD. Let me show from where it is coming. Open file location. This is where it is coming from. So if you click on it, it will give you what are all the features you enabled with this AD Connect server. So it is telling currently in progress. That is why I'm not able to open the configuration. Fine. I'm going to stop it. Let me open it because the MIS client it was running. That's why it is direct sync cannot be processed, can be made during this time, currently in progress. What it is doing, it is not syncing anything.
After the synchronization, instead of this error, tasks will come, no?
Excuse me?
Here the error is showing error, no?
Right.
Error. Instead of error, if it is working correctly, tasks will come, additional tasks, right?
No, it is not error. See, what I am trying to do, MIS client, which means directory sync is running, okay? Now okay. I am launching AD Connect installation file, installation path, which means to show what and all features I've installed on this box. See what it is telling, synchronization is currently in progress. Okay. So AD Connect direct sync is in progress. That is why it is giving this error.
Okay, that's okay. If it is not that work is not there,
uh-huh.
Actually additional tasks must come, no, there in that window there where we can customize the device write back option.
Correct. So that I will show you.
Okay.
So I have checked the MIS client is not running and also sync is not this one. This is what you are telling, right? So currently I stopped this one. So this is the screen you will get it. If you go and do this, see we've current configuration. Okay. So I want to see only current configuration. This is how it will look like. So what it is giving, see source anchor it is and user principal name. There is no write back and nothing enabled with this box. and auto upgrade, I've disabled everything, it is showing back. And now if you want to go ahead and enable some new features, you need to provide your credentials again.
Okay.
You can go ahead and enable that new features. So as soon as you go ahead and enable this, the new agents will get start publishing for that purpose. What is happening? So this is the domain, fine, and next. So these are now you can go ahead and write back option, you can enable it. User group write back and all. This is in preview mode, that's why it is not showing. As soon as it is allowing write back, you can go ahead and enable it.
How can we enable it? It is showing a gray out right now.
Let me check off it, and I will let you know this feature.
Okay.
I've not checked that because I've not enabled or group write back. So let me check for that. So you can go ahead and enable that. If I want to enable password write back here, and I can go ahead and write back. So any user, now this user, they can change password in cloud also. So previously it was only on premises. Now it will start writing back to cloud also. I mean from cloud to on premises. So new feature will get installed in this way. Enable password write back. It is taking some time. Saving synchronization settings. So it is installing health agent as well. So I will show you in the tenant how it will look like in Azure portal and Office 365 portal. Let it complete. Parallelly, I will log into the Azure portal. This is what it is, portal.azure.com. You have to go to Azure Active Directory and AD Connect. And if you see here, it synced last 1 hour back, and sync status is enabled, and the purpose of that domain, user sign in, pass through authentication, seamless it is being used here. And if you see the password authentication agent, it will be same server. Let me take you the health agent. Azure Active AD Connect Health. So latest data is not up to date because health agent, agent, I have not installed agent. As soon as you install agent, it will go on to get the errors also. And it will tell you what is the server being configured and what is the status of that. Last export to Azure Active Directory, exported. All the status will get it from here. The status of the AD Connect, you will get it from here. If you want to get it from Office 365, log in to the portal.office.com. And go to administrator, admin pen. You can see here last 27 minutes ago, last thing happened, it is in green. So it will tell you how many domains are verified and how many domains not verified, last sync status, directory sync enabled, password sync enabled, all those things it will give you. And if you have any errors, you can use the download ID fix tool and that you can use it to correct the errors if you have anything. By default, in your case, when abc.com and two different users, example on-prem user one dot user one at abc.com, cloud user one at xyz.com, when you stamping on-prem user with user one at xyz.com again, right, what will happen, that particular SMTP address will not get synced into cloud. You will get errors here in this place. Directory sync will tell you that there are some errors. If you go ahead and check that errors, it will tell you this SMTP address is already exist in the cloud. That is where you have to go and correct that errors. You need to check in AD Connect, you will get the object, what it is, which one is mismatching. Based on that, you can go ahead and correct in cloud also. Right, now let me tell you some additional information for you. That is how to troubleshoot AD Connect server issues. You are running something, see, you are facing some issues that AD Connect server is not running. It is giving some errors here. In my case, if you see, everything is Delta export, import, synchronization, everything is fine. You will get some errors, right? If you are getting some errors, by default, it is required internet access, okay? Internet access in terms of if your environment using proxy, you need to go ahead and provide unauthenticated internet to this server IP address so that server will contact to the Microsoft URLs without any blocks. If you are still you want to use a proxy and you want to use email address, identity for the authentication for the proxy for internet, you need to go and update in web.config file.net or .net place. If you update that, then internet will be fine and you will not face that error. And when you are seeing, if you are seeing any export with errors, export with errors means you will get some errors here telling that I'm not able to export for that user in terms of say example user one, as I mentioned, user one xyz binded in on-premises but same user available in cloud, you will get errors here. You can go ahead and check that user, which user is facing that issue, and you can correct that, right? That one you can do using errors. By default, you try to clear all the errors. Otherwise, their address book or for some reason you will face issues. Maximum try to clear that all the errors. As soon as you are getting some export or import errors, try to clear it in on-prem, also in cloud. And additionally, you want to sometime you will get some update telling that some users, okay, user one created and their mailbox needs to be synced, moved to cloud, or your manager or senior vice president, someone they updated mobile numbers, that has to be synced to cloud, right? As soon as you update in on-premises, it will, if sync is already initiated, that will take some time. Based on your configuration, if you want to go ahead and immediately do that sync up, you can go and do meta search for that user. Say example, user one updated something, and you are seeing some updates for this user here. See here, changes are nothing, right? If you want to, if you are seeing some updates here that has to go to cloud immediately for this user, what you can do, as soon as you are seeing, there are two connectors created, right? One is for cloud, another one is for on-premises. So in on-premises, if you are seeing some changes are there for that user that has to be synced to cloud immediately, what you can do, as soon as you are seeing add or modify or update is there for that user, go and do preview. Here, generate preview. What will happen? It will go on to generate for that user new preview and see the changes here. See, this is the connector for on-premises and see the previews. What is update is required for this user. Say in this case, unchanged is there. And if you are seeing some changes there, what you can do, immediately you can go to here, commit the preview. What will happen? It is going and getting the information from one directory and you are committing that immediately. You are forcing for this particular user in this time. So what will happen? As soon as you commit, it will ask you, regenerate preview, do you want to continue? Yes. So this particular user object, though the sync is in progress, this particular user object will take a privilege and it will go and sync up. So these are all the stuffs you can use it during the time of troubleshooting or during the time of some updates you want to force it for the particular users. So these are all the URLs you can go ahead and check. If I missed something, say example architecture level or default configuration or prerequisites, you can go ahead and check this article. This article is very much provided with all the information. Please go and have a visit. You will get more information about this. Okay, you have any questions?
Can you explain a little bit about ADFS also?
Right, ADFS, why it came in picture, right? Previously, Active Directory, your on-premises is there completely. You are not exposed to outside your corporate network. Why you are not exposing it to internet? Because it is RPC protocol used. RPCs can be easily hackable, right? So normally organization, they will get a fear. How should I allow to internet, outside world? Because all the information will be there, including username, passwords, and other informations. So ideally, organization, they will not allow their, internal Active Directory stuff to the outside world. So Microsoft, when cloud came in picture, Microsoft or other, cloud providers, they wanted some solution in terms of getting access, right? So if user created only in cloud, yes, you no need to have any on-prem username and password, you directly go and access. What if in case on-prem user, they want to access cloud, right? That time they have a challenge. How to mitigate this challenge? That is where ADFS came in picture. This ADFS has been introduced along with 2008. It came as ADFS 1.0 and then it got other latest versions. Now ADFS 2016 is there. How it is working, right? By default, ADFS is a token-based authentication. Active Directory works based on Kerberos tokens. ADFS working based on the token-based. So token-based in terms of you can keep it as a mediator between your Active Directory and the application provider. Application in terms of Office 365 or other AWS other. Right. So what happens, ADFS, right? As soon as you are trying to access the application will send out a request to the ADFS. ADFS will play as a mediator, right? What will happen? You are accessing application send a request to ADFS as an identity provider. ADFS, it will send a request to backbone Active Directory. This ADFS will be placed in DMZ and backbone. DMZ will be web placed. So it will go and talk to Active Directory in the Kerberos. Active Directory by default gives a Kerberos token to ADFS. ADFS, it will convert that as a secured token in terms of SAML or WS Federation is the token providers. So it will convert based on that. That token will be sent to application. That token is very much secured, and application only can be used the token for giving the access, right? So that is why ADFS is a mediator between application and Active Directory. It is not doing any additional, you know, authentication, just you know, sending the request from application to Active Directory and passing the token from Active Directory to the applications. You got it? You want more information?
Yes. Yeah, and how this ADFS is being synced with works with AD, Azure Active Directory.
So, what will happen when you configuring you know, Exchange Hybrid or Azure Hybrid, right? During that time, Microsoft provides two things. I will show you again that options to you. Let me go here. Sorry, let me go to Azure AD Connect. See here, federation. There will be federation and pass-through authentication. Okay. If you see, if, pass-through means it is managed. Managed means cloud only, that authentication will happen through. Okay. As soon as you click and try to enable federation, it will ask you, please provide your on-prem ADFS URLs. Okay, so that time you need to provide your on-prem ADFS URLs. That URLs will be considered as a, you know, request passing URLs. For example, this AD Azure will send request to that particular URL as a ADFS URL. Then there is, then only ADFS will come in picture as soon as it is seeing that request and sending back. So how ADFS is understanding, this is the person contacting me. Yes, I need to give authentication token to him, right? So as soon as you add, you are, you converting it as a federated tenant in your ADFS, you need to add the add this Azure, I mean Office Microsoft Azure tenant as a relay party, trusted person, okay, in ADFS. So as soon as it is seeing Azure is contacting ADFS, right? ADFS will go and check in ADFS database. Oh, this person is, you know, trusted by me. Yes, I need to contact and give the token to him. So mutual understand between Azure and ADFS using Azure will convert as a federated. ADFS will add Azure as a relay party, trusted, you know, application source. So this is where you are converting. This is where you need to convert them as a federated domain. As soon as you convert federated domain, the request will not get authenticated in Azure. That will get passed to the application, I mean ADFS URL. Okay.
Yeah.
Anything else you want? Right, Prabhu, you asked OU means organizational units, exactly right. It's subfolders in Active Directory database. You will not call it as Active Directory database, it is called as hierarchy. OUs are called hierarchy in Active Directory. And okay. If you guys have any questions, please you know, ask right away. Otherwise, we will you know, almost 1 hour we delayed. We can end up the session. Okay. Excuse me.
Hello, Radhakrishnan.
Yes.
Can we get this recording?
Definitely, we will get it.
But okay, thanks. Yeah, thank you.